from Lake Mission Viejo in the city of Mission Viejo. It is Utterback and Kurt Riedel taking on his brother, Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones. Two brothers playing against each other. Tell me about that.
I can't tell you how much emotion is in this event right here. The Utterbacks are five brothers, and there's so much emotion between the brothers. See who's the best player. Besides that, you got a lot of young talent out here. You got brothers going. It couldn't ask for any more. It's going to be great.
Well, everybody is pretty much anxious to get this started. Steve will be with me through the entire show, two semifinals and also a finals. And reporting from side court will be Bobby Stout. She'll be interviewing players, trainers, umpires, and everybody else around. Around here at Lake Mission Viejo, a festive atmosphere. When we come back, semifinals number one from Lake Mission Viejo. If you're caught out in the freeway, remember that A1 Transmission Service is your stop for all your transmission needs, serving all of Orange County.
Well, I drive my truck about 100 to 150 miles a day, so it's important that I have my truck. I noticed it was hard shifting on the freeway one day. I brought the truck home, and the next day there was a puddle of fluid underneath it, so I knew I had a problem. I called three different places for an estimate, and then I called a friend who recommended me to A1 Transmission. I called them. They had very reasonable prices. They promised to deliver it to me in a quick, timely fashion. They promised to use quality parts, which in fact they did, and they also promised free towing. So I got the whole package in one. And the best thing of all is my truck runs great, the service was fantastic, and I'd recommend A1 Transmission to a friend.
With locations in both Santa Ana and Mission Viejo, A1 Transmissions eliminates the middleman. Give them a call for complete driveline repair.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Dimension Sports in cooperation with Athletes in Motion for today's Game of the Week. Today from the city of Lake Mission Viejo, semifinals number one. We'll have two semifinals and then a final match later, a little bit later on in the show. Right now we've got Dwayne Utterback and Kurt Riedel taking on Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel taking on Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones.
You see Chad Jones there just ripped it right off the head of Kurt Riedel, knocked his hat right off his head. We got a couple guys out here. We got Kurt Riedel and Chad Jones, both that can fly, Paul. I don't know if you've seen these guys play before, have you?
Yes, I have.
Oh, it's unbelievable. This right here, coming back to serve, Chad Jones is one of the highest jumpers I've seen in some time.
Chad Jones, there's no score. Opening of semifinals number one. And he kind of dinks it over to the left. And we were talking about what type of serves that they would go for today, Steve Friedman, because you've got a wind that picks up a little bit in the afternoon. And I know that you guys, time to time, like doing those floaters.
I tell you, the wind, people don't understand who don't know volleyball as well as I do or other people who've been playing long enough. The element that the wind plays in this game, it becomes so much of an advantage to have the wind. So you want the wind blowing right into your face is what you want. And right now, Dwayne, who's serving, has the disadvantage. He's serving downwind. So Darren is hitting into the wind, which is, he just received the serve. It's much easier to hit into the wind.
And they're going for the first point. There is no score yet.
Little brother rivalry here. Darren keeps hitting it, and Dwayne keeps digging it.
And that will take care of that as Chad Jones bumps it over or knocks it over for the first point of the game, so it is 1-0.
I tell you, Dwayne is extremely pumped up for this game. You can tell in his face on that fight. He jumped up and down after that score.
You've got
Utterback and
Chad Jones have the score of 1-0. Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones lead it, and right now you've got Dwayne Utterback serving.
I played with Dwayne in the, a couple years this tournament was. He's an extremely emotional player.
And that ball is in, but there was a net violation, so a side out goes back to the other side of Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel.
You see Kurt and Darren back there. When they're serving the ball right now, if they serve the ball with any backspin on it, the ball will carry long because they're serving directly into the wind. If they spin it with any topspin, the ball will drop dramatically. So watch, Darren will, I guarantee you, put a topspin on it. Watch this. There it is.
And there is the topspin. Chad Jones at the net, powers it down.
Nobody up, and he just unloads. I tell you, you got to put a block up on these guys. These guys hit the ball unbelievably hard, and there's too much court to not block. There's an awful lot. Darren and Dwayne, I would say, are the two better setters out on the court, and the other two guys are the two better hitters. So if I were the other team, I would definitely not be serving the ball at the better hitters. Make sure that they're not the ones that are getting the receptions.
Chad Jones serving it. That ball goes over his head, so it'll be a side out back to Darren and Kurt Riedel.
You can see Darren there wasn't sure what to do. He had a humongous block in front of him, and he decided to cuff it off the top. That's a scary feeling when you got the ball set right up there and you see nothing but a giant wall of a guy.
Kurt Riedel serving it. Had all four of these gentlemen on coach's corner. Really interesting to see. Actually, I had three of the four. I did not have Dwayne on. There's so many other backs floating around this lake today.
They all are good players, too.
Yes, they are.
They've been playing since they were kids. And I remember when little Damien was just starting, and Dwayne and I were out in the backyard peppering with him, teaching him how. And he's the up-and-coming utterback. He's going to be the next one.
The hit there by Kurt Riedel goes off utterback's top of his hands. It goes out of bounds. And while I have the moment, I want to thank GKN Rentals. They are the reason why we have the great seat we do tonight, Steve, on top of the scaffolding. GKN Rentals on Geronimo and Alicia in Mission Viejo. Their phone number is 951-5666, and they have all your rental needs from forklifts to drill bits. And I'll be telling you that number throughout the show, because I know sometimes you need a gardening tool, or you need something automotive, or something to help you with your automotive, or help you with different things out there and around your landscape, and these guys have it.
I was in the contracting business for some time, and I tell you, you can't have every tool. It's impossible.
Yeah.
So you got to rely on these people that have every tool that, you know, when you need that one tool you use periodically, that's the best.
I want to thank Richard over there, GK and Reynolds. And right now the score 1-0 still. Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones leading it 1-0.
Okay, Darren's probably going to use the win and cut it here, my guess. Oh, nice deep lob again. I tell you, you got to get up high to get it over him. He gets up high. Chad gets way up. I'm surprised Darren's having success going over Chad because he is so high. Right now, if Chad, you see how Darren was coming into the wind? The best and easiest shot is to cut it sharp cross court. But he's using the harder, which is over, which is surprising me. Dwayne was relying on the cut.
Nice soft serve by Kurt Riedel.
See, there was the cut shot, and Kurt blocked it.
And at the net.
When you got a big blocker like that, you got to rely on having a good cut to get around him. Kurt jumped about 2-3 feet to his right the last second. I don't know if you saw that and happened to get a hold of Dwayne there. Kurt is another one that can climb. I mean, it's amazing how high these guys get.
Score is 1-1. If you're wondering what a cut shot is, it's a ball hit at a sharp angle across the court.
See that? Kurt dropped to serve short right in front of Dwayne. Dwayne made a great save to pop it up, and Chad hit it over. Great play by Dwayne.
And from time to time, we'll have Bobby Stout reporting from courtside. And the score again, Steve, 1-1. They've had a lot of side outs.
The thing that people don't realize is how much experience goes into this. You see a lot of, there's a couple veterans out here and a couple younger guys out here. You got to have the right combination. You don't see too often too many. See, Darren over the top again. It's surprising he's able to do that. Chad's a little frustrated. He's surprised, I think.
And Dwayne looks a little frustrated.
Well, the reason being is nobody has been able to have success over Chad. And Dwayne is expecting him to cut it, and they're getting it over Chad, so they're both a little bit surprised. Darren must be jumping a little higher than normal. He's so excited here.
Score tied at 1 still.
There's that nice top spin serve by Darren. Nice set by Dwayne. Over the top by
and side out.
Chad over the top of Kurt. Those two right there are going against each other about the same height, so they kind of negate each other's abilities.
Also like to thank the Healthy Gourmet Natural Cuisine for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. They supplied the food today. And for our crew, I'm sure hopefully they'll be able to eat between the semifinal match number 1 and number 2.
It looks like Chad's going to try a downwind jump serve. The chances of getting this in are very slim, but if he does, it'll probably be a great one. It's a nice serve, and he passed it perfect.
At the net. Kurt Riedel gets over the top of Chad Jones for another side out, and Steve, the score still remains 1-1.
This is going to go a long time. I'll tell you right now, this game will be long. This team right here, like I said, you got a couple veterans, a couple young guys. You don't see too many young teams out here. The young teams have lost the close ones earlier. You got to have some guys out here with some experience that have been in this situation before, which Darren and Dwayne both have, I believe.
At the net again.
Little joust at the net, and Dwayne cuffed it over. Nice hit by Darren, just long.
So the score still remains at one apiece, and this will tire these guys out, if anything.
Paul, you and I are going to be very happy sitting up here in these chairs. These guys, I do not envy these guys. I've got a little rib problem going, and I'll tell you, I'm kind of happy to be sitting up here today. I did not want to be out here grueling in this heat. It's got to be 95 out here. What would you guess?
I say you're about right.
It's unbelievable.
It was 80 this morning at the beach in Dana Point. When I got here
it was
80. Boy, I tell you, I felt it.
We got to get an update. Somebody's got to know the temperature down here. Lake Mission Viejo is notorious for carrying a little extra heat, too.
Yeah.
If it's 90 at my house, you come here, it's 95 because of the reflection off the water.
Good point. Very good point.
I tell you, it's beautiful, though. You couldn't beat a day like this, except for playing.
Chad Jones and Dwayne Utterback in the near corridor on the right side of your screen, depending on the picture you're looking at.
There's your cut shot by Darren. Did you see that? He used the wind, put a little topspin on it, cut it down. Dwayne made a great pass out there. Chad's got to get Dwayne up there where he can take a good swing at it. That's the thing here. Chad and Kurt are the two younger. The blue trunks with the black hat, Chad, and Kurt with the red and white shorts are the younger players. And younger players generally can hit better, but their setting is not as accurate as the older players.
Still looking. They've got a 2-1 now.
Good set by Chad, but he set him a little too tight, and Kurt was all over him. Look at that dig by Darren. Unbelievable dig by Darren.
And a nice save.
And Dwayne with a great save back.
A great save so far. Chad Jones and Dwayne Utterback down by one.
There you go. Hey, I rest my case. Would you see that right there? Kurt Riedel, the younger player, tried to set it with his hands, and he called for lift right there. That's where the younger players, they can hit definitely better, but the older players are the ones with the hands for setting. You got the two pro refs here, so I don't think there's any disputing the call.
No. Excellent referees.
You don't see a whole lot of bickering by the players. They knew it was the throw.
Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel. And Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones.
Here comes a big boom.
There's Kurt Riedel at the net over Chad Jones.
You're right through. It's the old field goal. He hit it off the top of his head there. Kurt can climb, and he can hit it hard, too, to boot.
2-1 the score. Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel leads it 2-1.
Okay, wait here. It's 3:00 now, Paul. This game's going to be at least another hour, my guess. We're talking a grueler here. This is my guess. If somebody gets on a great serving roll on the far side, right where they're serving now, this could go quicker. Otherwise, this is going to be a long game.
First team to 15 by 2 wins.
Dwayne with a nice cross court. See, the set is the key, Paul. If your partner sets you good, you're home free. It's difficult enough out here. The elements, you're in deep sand. You got the wind blowing. You got a couple thousand people here. It's tough enough. If the set is not there, it's very tough.
Yeah.
You got to have a good set. And Chad set Dwayne up beautifully, and he buried it. That's the key to this game. And my thing, everybody's so good at this point.
Short little timeout by Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones. We'll take a timeout after the next point served.
See, Dwayne's serving downwind here. Dwayne's got an excellent into the wind serve here. His down the wind serve, you just want to keep it in. That's all you really want to do.
And he does do that. Utterback at the net goes wide. We're going to take a short timeout, step aside. Right now, the score is 2-1. Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel, they lead it here at Lake Mission Viejo.
As one of the top resorts in the world, the magnificent Ritz-Carlton Laguna Niguel is California's only five-star, five-diamond resort. You'll enjoy nightly entertainment and world-class cuisine. And of course, you'll love the Ritz-Carlton's uncompromising commitment to personal service. Right now, the Ritz-Carlton Laguna Niguel has a sensational midweek resort getaway for just $199 per night, single or double occupancy. For information, call 714-240-2000, the Ritz-Carlton Laguna Niguel.
Well, I would recommend Cartoon to my best friend because of what it has done for me. It really, Dr. Olinger has taken me out of pain. I had pain for 3-4 years, sciatic nerve pain, lower back pain, due to my business. I'm in a stressful situation. And the treatment and therapy that they have here is just fantastic. And I would want my friends to be able to get the same kind of treatment.
Call Lakeway Chiropractic at 830-3391.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the 11th annual Miller Lite Midsummer Volleyball Classic. The score in the first semifinals game is 2-2. Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel taking on Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones. And down court side, as the score now is 3-2, Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel is Bobby Stout. Bobby is down there with Bobby Friedman. Bobby, take it away.
thanks, Paul. With me right now is Bobby Friedman, the other half of Steve Friedman. And Bobby, earlier I was talking to both the Utterback brothers, and I found it interesting that the brothers aren't split up for any emotional reasons or anything. Actually, it's more of an intellectual reason. Tell me about that.
Well, they're both defensive players, and I don't think their styles would flatter each other. I think that they'd play well together, but they both need to have an offensive, big hitter to flatter each other. So I don't think it has anything to do with brotherly love. I think it has to do with wanting to win this tournament.
And that's exactly what the other two players are on their team.
Yeah, extremely competitive, and I feel Dwayne and Chad will pull this off. We'll see, but I have a feeling Chad is just unbelievable. I think he's great. I have a feeling they're going to pull this one out.
All right, well, it's going to be a competitive game, so let's go back to the action.
Thanks a lot, Bobby, and Bobby Friedman. Steve, we weren't able to hear what your brother was saying, but I wouldn't doubt if he's been talking about his great success here and also maybe his loss that he suffered earlier.
Yeah, it wasn't expected. I mean, I'm not one for excuses personally. I hate people who give excuses, and I'm not going to point a finger at him, and I hope he doesn't do the same to me. We both could have played better. I've got a minor rib injury here, possibly a broken rib. I'm not sure. I aggravated about 3 years ago, and you know, obviously that didn't help, and we haven't played together, and so at this point, I'm not going to give excuses, but, you know, there's a lot of young talent out here. Next year, we both decided it's probably better we go our separate ways and play with other people, which could be quite exciting for both of us. I mean, I drop down to an A-rated level next year, so it kind of is cool. I can play with anyone on the beach I want.
That's fantastic.
And in the past, I've been restricted because I was I was rated AAA. So next year, I could play with Mike Minear or an Alan Vistante or possibly just a Toby Braun. I mean,
it'll be fun to see.
Yeah, my potential is going to be fun next year anyways.
Well, the score now is 4-2, Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones. They have the lead.
Oh, my goodness.
Big hit there by Darren Utterback.
He unloaded on that one. He got all of that one. Kurt, I tell you, I played with Kurt, goofed around with him a couple of years ago. His setting has improved dramatically. He set the ball beautifully with his hands right to Darren. Darren unloaded on it.
4-2.
That's the key. Like I say, Paul, you got to be able to set your teammate. And that's, I think if Chad and Dwayne I know can set. Dwayne is an excellent setter. If Chad can set well, I think that they have a very good chance of winning. Here's Chad with the hands. Beautiful set. Dwayne put it away.
Nice down the line shot by Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones. Looking over the times that you have won this event back in 1984, Steve Friedman won it along with Steve Friedman and Dwayne Utterback defeated John Geis and Bob McDonald. So that's the first time you won it back in 1984. Here it is.
Yeah.
Next year, the 10th anniversary of your first win.
I'm getting old, Paul. My wife drives a Volvo. I got one kid and one dog. I'm getting old the American way here. It's feeling funny.
At the net.
I don't know. You heard about the wife 8 months pregnant?
Yes, I did. Congratulations.
We're expecting a boy.
I'm sure it's going to be a big boy.
A very large
boy. Your wife is over 6 feet tall.
He's going to be big and slow,
yes.
Just like his papa.
You're what, 6'5"?
I'm 5'17".
Yes.
6'5". There you got it right.
6'5". And your wife, how tall is she?
She's about 5'11".
5'11". So you will have a big, big young man.
Yeah.
And I'm Paul Higgins, along with Steve Friedman. I'm chatting with up here at the...
There's the cut shot by Dwayne. Can you see that, how he used the wind there? Beautiful cut shot by Dwayne. There's the veteran right there.
4-2, and side out goes back. We had a game of 1-1 for quite some time, and then when we stepped away, we had Utterback and Jones scoring point.
Okay, my prediction. Let's see how true I come here. I told you it was going to be an hour long if nobody got on a serving roll there, okay? Dwayne scored a couple points over on the good side. Dwayne has got an excellent serve. When Dwayne gets that serve going, watch out. He can hit it hard and in. Okay, Darren's going to be serving downwind here.
Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel. Kurt at the net, Darren serving.
I know you've played a million sports, Paul. You do just about everything. Have you played a whole lot of volleyball?
I've played a share of a novice volleyball, I guess you could say. I can go out and hit the ball.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun. I mean, it's something that I think that I went down the other alley because I thought it was a big man's game, and obviously it's a pretty big man's game.
Big helps. It's not a prerequisite. There's guys out there that are not big that are spectacular, but it definitely helps to be big. So I can't say that. But
yeah.
The reason I brought that up is if you've played the game, then you can critique others' abilities and say how hard it is. As long as you've got out there, I don't care what level, you know how high that net is.
Yeah.
And you know how hard it is to jump out of the sand, so you can relate.
I can relate just how hot it is out here, you know? just getting up on the scaffolding, let alone jumping 40 inches in the air.
Shot. Dwayne tried the cut there, and Kurt was all over it.
4-2, the score remains.
4-3.
4-3, pardon me now.
He blocked for a point. I tell you, right now, both of these teams have kind of gotten how they have, especially Dwayne and Chad on blocking. Chad has blocked a lot of balls. Chad is going to have a lot more trouble with Darren and Kurt. They're both a little bit more experienced here.
Here's Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel, they lead it 4-3.
There you
big
go.
Big block at the...
Okay, did you see what happened there, Paul?
Well, pardon me, I gave you guys the wrong score. It's all tied now. Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones, they were leading, but Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel have come back and scored a couple points. Tell you what, trying to keep these Utterbacks straight is difficult.
See that athletic play by Kurt right there. Dove on the floor, dug it up, Darren put it away.
Nice play out there on the court. 4-4. And there is a timeout on the court as these two guys and their partners go over and get a drink of water. We'll come back with more volleyball right after this. The score 5-4. Dwayne Utterback, Darren Utterback, and Kurt Riedel, they lead it.
It's unbelievable, simply incredible. A bicycle tire that never goes flat. For anyone who rides a bike, listen to this.
The no-flat bicycle tire is probably one of the greatest inventions we've had in the last 30 years. The no-flat bicycle tire will not go flat. The no-flat bicycle tire will allow you to ride the bicycle any part of the street. You can ride over glass, you can ride over nails, you can ride over just about anything. And the best part about it is you don't have to worry about having a flat tire. So you have total peace of mind when you're riding.
It's called the no-flat bicycle tire. It lasts 2 to 4 times longer than air tires, weighs within 20 grams of a tube tire, and it's made in the USA. After years of scientific study, the no-flat bicycle tire is going to revolutionize the biking industry, and it comes in sizes for all bikes. For information or to order your own set of the no-flat bicycle tire, call 714-263-0208. The no-flat bicycle tire will never go flat.
I think it's great that they'll never go flat and they'll never have to change the tires again.
Welcome back to the Athletes in Motion's Dimension Sports Game of the Week. The score 9-5. Utterback and Riedel lead at 9-5 over Utterback and Jones. Down courtside, Bobby Stout has another interview ready, and this was with Mike Wilhelm, an excellent volleyball player.
Make a lot of changes.
Thanks, Paul. With me right now is Michael Wilhelm. He was in the tournament earlier yesterday and unfortunately dropped out today. Tell me about the tournament. What do you think about it, Mike?
Well, this is one of my favorite tournaments to play in, basically because this is run like an AVP tournament more than any other of the FOBAs or the CVVAs. What's so exciting about it is the TV cameras are here. They always draw a large crowd, and they have announcement booths. Gives it a real professional atmosphere.
Tell me, as a spectator and as, you know, a volleyball person yourself, what's going on in the game here today?
Well, right now, Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel are starting out real strong, and Chad's block, Chad Jones, is not a factor right now. If he can get his hands on the ball, the game can turn around instantly.
All right, well, thanks. Good luck to you, or congratulations on playing, and let's go back to the game.
Thank you.
Welcome back, and Bobby Stout talking with Mike Wilhelm. The score 10-5, a lot of side outs, and they pretty much have run away with it right now, Steve. We were locked at side outs for a while. Nobody was scoring. And then all of a sudden, Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel take off on a scoring spree.
Hey, as you recall, I made a couple predictions. I said this would be an hour-long brawl. We're a little over halfway, and it's been almost a half an hour, so I'm pretty on track. I told you the only thing that could change that is serving. And obviously serving from the good side was the factor. Darren was over on the good side serving into the wind, caused a lot of trouble. Great serves by Darren. And I got it in the defense of Dwayne and Chad Jones. In their defense, the wind drops the ball dramatically, and Darren just put the ball on the spot, and they were diving to touch the ball. So it caused a lot of trouble, and they scored four or five straight points. They scored on the good side. So once again, the good side is the factor. Now you see Dwayne and Chad are on the good side. If Riedel and Darren Utterback can score a few points right now, this game will be over. Otherwise, Dwayne and Chad have to score a lot to hang in there.
Darren Utterback serving to his brother, Dwayne.
Dwayne and Chad have the good side. And, Dwayne
and he
puts
finds
away.
It.
Dwayne puts it away.
You side can, out goes back
you see what's
the other
going
side.
On here is Riedel's blocking his cross-court cut shot, which is Dwayne's best shot. And Darren is standing there in his line and trying to bait him to hit it at him. And Dwayne went over the top of him and put it in. So Dwayne hit the excellent shot there.
Again, 5 serving 10 right now.
He's got the excellent wind to serve in. Perfect serve, perfect pass. Called a throw on Riedel. The young man, exactly what I called earlier. The setting is going to be a factor.
And right now, again, it's 10 to 6 now. 6 serving 10. Got off to a slow start of 1-1 for probably 10 different side outs back and forth.
You see, 6 straight points have been scored on the good side. So that's how much of an advantage you have on the good side. He could come up with a couple aces here. This could be a good game again. Great serve. Darren, beautiful set.
Riedel at the net with Jones, and Jones takes care of it.
So now you see how much the good side helps. 7 straight points are on the good side. So, I mean, that is a humongous factor. Just the coin toss in this wind is a definite impact on the game score.
Wind is to our backs, and it's to the backs of Riedel and Utterback.
He hasn't yet come up with an ace, but I'll guarantee you one here within the next couple if he gets 2 more tries at it.
Chad Jones serves it up.
And there's one. That's not an ace, but that's the next closest thing.
And he can't get it up on the bump, so 10-7. He's not too happy about that.
I tell you, there's nothing more frustrating when you get the guy to shank it over the net and give it to you, and you can't put it away. That was an excellent serve by Chad there.
Now let's see if Riedel can get the serve in and make you do a little scoring drought here on this side.
He's serving downwind. Dwayne will cut it right here. Here's the cut, wide open. Blocked.
Great block by Riedel at the net.
You see what he did there? He suckered him. He said, go ahead, hit it cross court. And the last second, Riedel jumped 3 feet to his right and blocked it. Dwayne had the perfect wind to do what he did. Kurt just made a great play.
New addition to the volleyball tourney this week is the ball boys on either end of the court.
I tell you, we've reached big time over here at Lake Mishaveo.
Utterback at the net. And you could see Riedel, he kind of got caught in his footsteps and tried to go back. Utterback went over his head for the score.
The thing I'm impressed with, Paul, I've known all these players. I've known Kurt. Kurt has improved dramatically setting, but I'm very impressed with Chad's ability to set the ball. He's setting the ball right on the target to Dwayne. Dwayne is he likes his sets to be right where they're supposed to be. And Dwayne's not bitching at him, so you know he's pretty happy with where he's getting his sets. They usually argue a little bit, you know, when the sets aren't on, your partner will yell at each other.
A fight at the net, and then Riedel comes back with a big hit.
Kurt Riedel puts the ball away in the cross court.
And coming up next in semifinals, number 2, Steve Friedman, will be Mike Minear and Phil Levine taking on Aaron Garcia and Holloway.
That's going to be an exciting game.
Sure is.
There's 2 young, up-and-coming talents. I don't think there's any 2 better young physical talents out there right now. Aaron was one of the top 10 countries high school picks, and he's on a full ride to Stanford, so he's an excellent talent. Here's a great set by Chad again. Great play, Dwayne.
Dwayne dinks it over. And Kurt Riedel got brought in underneath the net. It could not give time enough for Dwayne to get back. Communication is everything in this game.
It is, Paul. It's funny you picked up on that because my feeling is communication is a big part of this game, especially out here. Because it never goes as planned. You got to let each other know. You got to come up with other plays at the last second.
Jones puts a nice power serve over.
Could be a block.
And it is.
There you go. See what happened there? Kurt set him a little tight. You got a guy climbing 3 feet above the net there. You're not going to get it by him. If you put it within a foot of the net, he's going to block him. And sure enough, I saw that he set him tight. And Darren's a little upset with his partner, but he doesn't want to yell at him. He wants to keep his composure. They are winning by 3 points, so Darren's not going to get upset.
Score 8, serving 11. Jones is serving.
I see an ace coming up here, Paul. He's on a roll.
Nice serve. The bump is good. Can Riedel get to it? Yes, he does. Gets it over.
That's a kill.
Dwayne at the net, but that was held a little too long.
That's an unbelievably scary call. That was a real close. I don't know if I'd have called that. These are pro refs. They're going to be a little bit more particular about their sets than everybody else. But I tell you, I called an ace there, and he almost had him. And they got it over, and that's all it takes. You got to get it over, and you got a shot to stay alive.
Well, the Utterback family is guaranteed to be in the finals because you're looking at Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones taking on his brother Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel. Right now, Kurt Riedel is getting ready to serve with the score 11-8. First team that gets to 15 and wins by 2 gets into the finals.
Right there. That's something that I predicted would be a big element in this game. On 2 hitting there. And you see Chad hit that on 2. If Darren and Riedel here take advantage of that, I think they will be unstoppable. If they can hit it on 2 a little bit, catch them a little off guard, because you got big blockers here. Get a little quick play like that.
Serve is long and wide.
That ball's long.
Score is 11-8. Riedel over Jones. It's easier for us to say that because there's Utterbacks on both sides. So Riedel and Utterback have the lead 11-8. And they're serving right now.
The big joke around I've heard all day is if you yell Utterback, that there's so many Utterbacks, grandchildren, this, that, and the other. There's probably 10 young Utterbacks here. If you yell Utterback, you're going to probably have half the beach looking at you. So definitely got to go with a first name basis there.
I can't tell you how much time and effort goes into this event. You're looking at having it here at Lake Mission Viejo. Doug Hammond and Darrell Utterback doing a great job.
Watch for that ace again. He's due. He's very due. That's a nice serve. There, the beautiful set.
Riedel and Jones off Jones' hands. And it goes back the other way. Score 11-8.
You know, Paul, what people don't realize, the top of that net is 8 feet high. Okay, a basketball rim is 10 feet high. You're looking from our angle, we're up a little high, but I'm looking at Chad's shoulders. Okay, so we're talking his chin's over the net. He's getting well above a basketball rim. These guys are getting way up high.
Dwayne Utterback, he finds the line on the inside. It's good.
You see, Dwayne hit it directly into the way the wind is blowing. The wind is blowing right at Dwayne. Dwayne used a lot of wrist control. Didn't hit it real hard, but he snapped it right in the corner. It was a beautiful shot by Dwayne.
And the ball slowed down and the wind, too, to find that line.
The wind will knock it down. You got to use that wind. I'm teaching a class down here at Lake Mission Viejo on Mondays and Wednesday nights, and I try to teach the intermediate advanced class how much the wind comes into play. And I think a couple of them are really starting to realize how important it is. Nice deep floater by Dwayne.
8 serving 11. Jones at the net with Riedel, and Jones blocks it down.
Switch
so
sides.
The score is 11-8. When we come back, we'll have more in the final stretch to the finals coming up right after this.
Gin Japanese restaurant located in Laguna Niguel is proud to have opened their all-new sushi bar. For quality and friendly service, try Gin's Japanese cuisine. They have a wide variety of sushi and various entrees that will have you coming back again and again. The Gin is a perfect place for all special occasions. Visit Gin and experience Japanese dining at its best, a place for the entire family. Try Gin's all-new sushi bar or call for takeout at 643-0442.
In 1907, Pasadena's Huntington Hotel set the standard for gracious hospitality. Now masterfully rebuilt is the Ritz-Carlton Huntington Hotel. It's perfect for business or pleasure. You'll love dining in our three award-winning restaurants and dancing to live entertainment. Right now, the Ritz-Carlton Huntington Hotel has romantic getaways starting at just $119 per night. For reservations, call 818-568-3900. The Ritz-Carlton Huntington Hotel, 15 minutes from downtown Los Angeles.
Welcome back to the Midsummer Classic. The score 11-10 right now. A great semifinal matchup. I'm Paul Higgins along with Steve Friedman, winners of this event three times. Knocked out early in the bracket, but coming out on center court to do the finals, semifinals and the finals for me on TV.
I tell you, we just missed a couple great plays. We got a great rally going on here. The reverse spatula, I call that. Here goes Darren with the kill. I think Darren's going to put it down. Dwayne digs him. Darren gets another shot at it. Blocker's going to be late.
Jones at the net. Longest rally of the game so far, and he dinks it over for the score. That's a Toby Braun move.
That was a great shot. No call on the set. I was a little wondering about the set. Had a little bit of spin on it. They're going to be extremely difficult on the set. When you set it over your head, over the net, they're going to call it.
And we're all tied up at 11.
Darren's not too happy about that call.
No, he's sitting down at center court, and again, to kind of give you an idea, some of the winners of the event, we'll go back to last year. John Blackburn and Larry Barnett defeated Mike Minear and Phil Levine 15-11. In 1991, Toby Braun and Dave Civic knocked off Steve and Bobby Friedman 15-9.
Let's not talk about that one, though.
In 1990, Steve and Bobby defeated Darren Utterback and Tony Fasanelli. So those are the last three or four years of this event. Beautiful atmosphere at the Lake Mission Viejo right now.
I didn't realize it was
volleyball classic.
I didn't realize I was defeated so many times, Paul. I only remember my victories. I never remember my defeats.
Yeah, you're on the right side of this piece of paper a lot.
Hey, I mean, people will knock me. I came in second. How many times? One, two, three, four times.
Four times, second
but,
place.
Hey, second place is better than, you know, eighth place. Come
four
on.
Four times in second place ought to earn you a new car or something.
I always say that when I lose in a game. People say, how'd you do? Ah, I came in second. In a tournament, you know, I came in second. Doesn't sound as bad as I lost.
Yeah, exactly. You got to look at it from the positive end.
But no one remembers who came in second, Lake Michigan. You got to win this tournament.
That's right. Bragging rights for a year.
Oh, you got it.
Serving up, score tied at 11.
I tell you, Daryl and Doug Hammond have done a fantastic job. Daryl Utterback. Another Utterback, and Doug Hammond done a fantastic job setting this up. Every year it gets better and better and more professional. It's just, this is great.
It's a lot of fun. 12-11, Dwayne Utterback finds the inside part of the court.
I'm very surprised. They're on the bad side. Dwayne has scored three straight points on the bad side. Darren has to put the ball away here. Has to.
Watch the cut shot, and then he goes down right at his brother. Side out.
That was a situation where you saw Chad, see how high he jumped. He jumped so high, Darren hit it under him. He was up so high, Darren hit it underneath him. So sometimes it's not so how high you jump, it's how far you get over. Darren made a great hit there.
Score 12-11, 11 serving 12. Dwayne,
great serve.
Darren Utterback serves it long.
That's the right idea, you gotta go for that deep line.
And Chad Jones is taking a big sigh of relief right here. They have the lead, 12-11, he's serving on the side that they haven't been scoring a lot of points on.
He's doing a jumper downwind. Very dangerous serve.
Over the top, and it is dangerous. You see it goes long.
It's the hardest serve in the book, but as a passer, it's the hardest ball in the world to pass. If the guy gets that serve in, it is tough, and you'll guarantee it'll be deep. But now here you go. Kurt's going to do it. No, he's not going to do a jumper. He's going to do a standing. He'll probably do a spinner. We got a great breeze. He's probably going to try to cut it. Gives a deep floater to Dwayne.
At center court, at the center part of the net.
Holy
nice.
Cow.
Jones.
Chad made a great play.
They're not calling it though, Steve.
What are they calling it? Looks like they're calling a net on Dwayne. Dwayne must have netted. Chad made a spectacular play there to get that ball over. Kurt blocked Dwayne and Chad made an unbelievable play, but I guess Dwayne touched the net. And Dwayne's not arguing it, so it was the right call.
We're tied up at 12 once again. Riedel serving it.
It's a great cut serve. This could be trouble. Dwayne right on the line. Great cut.
Side out.
You see
tied at 12.
You see Kurt shuffle about 3 feet to his right to try to block that ball, take away Dwayne's cut. Dwayne's cut is his best shot, and Kurt knows that, and he was trying to take it away, and Dwayne still hit it.
Local event here at Lake Mission Viejo. It is the 11th annual Midsummer Classic.
I hate to say it, Paul, but I've been pretty accurate on my guesstimation on time here. We're getting pretty close, almost a quarter till now, or about three quarters of the way done. There's been a couple more quick scoring opportunities than I would have expected, but it has dragged on. Can you imagine how they feel out here? We're dying up here in the heat. They're playing in it.
They're playing in it. Guys in the truck, they're cool.
Yeah.
In our television truck here on the
big opportunity. Big opportunity for Dwayne.
Dwayne.
Oh, Darren.
Gets it to his brother Darren, and then Jones comes back. Riedel up for the block, but he couldn't get it in. So the score, 13-12. We'll have more volleyball right after this from Lake Michigan. The Sports Medicine and Master Center knows how important it is to maintain a healthy and comfortable relationship with their physical therapist or workout trainer.
It's extremely important that you develop a relationship with people that are patients. And as we develop relationships with these people, you become more than just a physical therapist or a patient. You become friends. And that's one of the reasons we've been so successful, because we've had people come back to us for rehabilitation for years and years, and we've developed a fairly large following in this community. And now what we're finding is those same people that were originally our patients are returning to join the health club to stay with us. And I think it's because we've formed a personal bond with these people that goes far beyond just a relationship on a medical level.
Located in Mission Viejo off of Crown Valley Parkway, the Sports Medicine and Master's Center caters to the individuals 30 and over. For information, call 582-3320. Welcome back to Lake Mission Viejo Midsummer Volleyball Classic. The score 13-12. Utterback and Riedel have the lead over Utterback and Jones. And Dwayne will be serving it with the lead, 13-12. Great athlete. Back in 1984 was the last time that Dwayne won an event here at Lake Mission Viejo. He's looking good. He's in great shape.
Yeah,
down.
I was mentioned to during the break there that Dwayne has lost a lot of weight. He's in excellent shape. And obviously, he's playing extremely well. It's been, an eight-year absence, and he's back out here in the finals looking great. Doing exactly what, Darren hit it wide. Doing exactly what I said he probably couldn't do is win on the bad side. And now he's taken the lead, and he's on the good side.
14-12.
So Dwayne is 1 point away from going to the finals, which is unbelievable.
Whoever the winner is, when we come back, Bobby Stow will interview the two winners. As we'll go down to court side and get ready for semifinals number two.
The thing that people aren't thinking about here is Kurt and Darren have made two of the best comebacks so far in this tournament. They've come back on two teams. They came back on Wilhelm, I believe, and also against Brian Godshaw. They had two games where they had them put away, and Darren and Riedel came back. So don't count Darren and Riedel out here.
Score is 14-12.
They've done it twice already, and I would not put it past them to do it again. Looks like Darren and Kurt are very confident in each other's ability. They're not afraid to give each other the opportunity here. You don't see them yelling at each other. They're very poised. But the only thing that's very scary here, it looks like they called another timeout, is Dwayne has got an excellent serve going into the win. So they've decided to take another timeout, one right on top of the other. You notice Darren and Kurt are spending a little time away from each other. And they don't want to yell at each other. They know they're having a few problems. They're not sitting right next to each other, which is very common. I like that. You know, you let yourselves just concentrate and get focused.
Well, our cameramen are on other things right now. They're not out there on Dwayne and
I think they're focusing on that
Darren
beach chair there,
and,
Paul. Yeah. You see that new beach chair there? That's an excellent new beach chair there.
Darren and Kurt Riedel, 2 points, down 2 points. You see a shot of the net, 8 feet high. And our camera operator, Mark Colson. These guys are working hard out there, but Mark Colson out there getting that shot, he's extremely hot right now carrying that camera, and the camera's about 25 pounds. That's where we should be right now in the water, Lake Mission Viejo.
I think we're going to hit the water during this break,
yes,
Paul, aren't we?
Yes, I think so.
I am very, very warm. Looks like Mark Chandler over there. You see him with the camera
under
there?
Mark Chandler.
Our photographer there, he's getting a nice sunburn going. He's looking a very interesting shade of pink there.
Mark Chandler standing right behind the head referee up there on the crates, and These are AVP referees. They do a great job. You see them on NBC doing the professional tournaments from Manhattan, and wherever those guys go, they follow them around.
I recently went to Mark's wedding. Mark was wedded about, 2 months ago, I believe it was, and married a real nice gal, and I'm pretty happy for him. He's been our photographer here for, I think, 10 years
yes,
now.
Yes, Mark Chandler. I never get to see the pictures he takes. I have to see him sometime.
Can anybody focus in on him? I don't know if anybody's even listened to us. He's underneath the main referee stand. He's got the camera there. He's been doing it for 10 years with Doug and Daryl. Daryl, he's been around the tournament. Here we go. Dwayne's going to serve. Excellent into the wind server, Dwayne. He could put this game away. He needs to put this game away right here.
Game point. Got to win by two.
He chose to go with a nice conservative serve.
Darren Utterback at the net. Powers it
down.
Jones couldn't get to it, so side out goes to Riedel in Utterback.
Like I said, these two here have come back from three games so far this tournament. They did it to Brian Godshaw and his partner, and they did it to, I believe, Mike Wilhelm, who was interviewed earlier. They came back from big deficits, comparable to this, so don't count them out.
Darren Utterback gets really quiet, and he goes pretty much keeps to himself in between the points.
He's a focused player. He's a very mentally tough player. Here, Dwayne's going to probably come up with that cut shot.
Got the whole left
there
side.
There it is.
He couldn't get it.
There was the cut shot. He went to the well, and Kurt was riding on it. Kurt was expecting it. Did you see where Kurt was?
Yes, he was.
He knew it was coming, and he wasn't there.
Kurt Riedel at the net. 14-13. 13 for Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel. They'll be serving. They're down by 1 point.
Now you see how much that side advantage comes through in the beginning of the game. Okay, now if they get to 16-14, 15-15, they're going to switch again. If Darren and Kurt can hang on, they're going to be tough.
Dwayne Utterback dinks
Nice shot.
Had his brother going the opposite way.
Darren thought for sure he's going to go to the cut. Dwayne made a great cut down the line.
So they'll serve for the match.
Yep.
A chance to get in the finals.
I have this saying, Paul, and let's see how Dwayne went with the conservative serve with the play before. I got a feeling Chad's going to unload. I have the saying, I say to myself, it's no guts, no glory. Let's see how he goes there. If he goes for it or if he just chooses to keep it in. I got a feeling he's going to unload. He's going to go for the hard jumper.
Chad Jones serves it on the jump.
See, he's got the guts. He went for the unload, and he dug him.
It's always easier to do that.
Oh!
Darren Utterback comes down with the smash. Side out.
You got to give Chad credit. I tell you, that is tough to do. People don't understand. There's a lot of pressure on that serve. I mean, he is winning, but the pressure's on him because he should win this game.
And you see Darren pretty much just kind of hangs by himself.
Yep. Darren's an extremely focused player. Now, I don't know who I'd serve it to. I got a feeling he's going to serve it to Dwayne because Dwayne had the problem with the last cut shot. I got a feeling if he were smart, he's probably going to go after Dwayne here and make Chad set the ball. Let's see what he does. He probably will. Let's see.
Kurt Riedel serving it.
He does.
Serves it to Dwayne.
Dwayne's going to come up with a big hit, I got a feeling.
Cut shot down the side. Pulls it off.
Exactly. Dwayne unloaded. That's the gutsy play by Dwayne. Forget the easy hit. He ripped it. The line, looks like Kurt's given Dwayne the line. I don't know if he's seen it. The line is wide open to unload, but he did rip it by him inside there.
Serving for the match.
He's going
chance,
for it.
Chance for the finals.
See that?
And this could be it, and it is.
Oh, that's...
And that is the last point as Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones defeats Darren Utterback and Kurt Riedel 15-13. When we come back, Bobby Stout will talk with the winners as they advance into the finals. Our second semifinals match coming up will be Mike Minear and Phil Levine taking on Garcia and Holloway. We'll be back with more of the Game of the Week right after this.
Stay tuned to Dimension Channel 3 and find out what's happening in your community. Teach your kids to draw cartoons step-by-step every day at 5:30 on Dimension Presents It's Cartoon Time with Kurt Visca. At 6, it's Seniors the Changing Scene with Rex Tyner and Agnes Garner, keeping you informed on South County seniors. Then join host Yvette Welch at 6:30 for Dimensions in the Community, focusing on people, places, and events in your community. At 7, join moderator Terry Waddell and a variety of guests on Dimension Forum discussing community issues that affect you. Then Paul Higgins puts our local sports heroes in the limelight every night at 7:30 on Coach's Corner. Followed by Game of the Week with Paul Higgins and Bill Cunerty, highlighting South Orange County High School sports as the best game in town. So stay tuned to Dimension Cable Channel 3 for all your local community programming.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the city of Mission Viejo. The first semifinals game, 15-13, won by Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones. Bobby Stout has the winners down their side of the court.
Thanks, Paul. With me right now is the winners, Dwayne Utterback and Chad Jones. Congratulations, guys. Tell me, first of all, how do you feel about the match?
I felt they played real strong in the beginning, but then at the end, it looked like they were getting a little tired. They took a couple consecutive timeouts, and they were both kind of bending over and catching their wind on the sidelines. I think conditioning might have played a little bit in this because it's really hot out here, and took a little out of them.
Tell me, what was the key to your victory today?
Well, I think we had a little easier road to this match, so they didn't get as much rest as we did. They've had a lot more playing time, and that had to have a lot to do with the reason they were tired.
Chad, you mentioned the heat. How did the heat and the fatigue affect your guys' game?
I don't think it really affected our game. I think we're in pretty good shape. My blocking was a little off that game, and actually you gotta give them some credit. They're a real good team. Kurt Reel's a good player, and I think that's basically it.
Did you guys feel confident coming into this match? I know you played so well on Saturday. Did you feel confident, or were you just kind of just going with it?
Well, you know, you just never know how the other team's going to play. They could come out on fire and hit every one of their serves, jump serves, and just bury them. And you really can't do much about that. But, you know, if a team's just playing about your level serving-wise, you know, anything can happen.
I felt very confident coming into this match, personally.
All right, great. Well, congratulations, guys. Okay, right after this, we'll have the second semifinal, so stay with us.
The city of Laguna Beach is known worldwide for its beauty.